Research at the Yale School of Management predicts that by 2027, 75% of leading US firms will lose their place to currently unknown companies. This indicates that to succeed in a time of ever-changing technology and needs requires fast, adaptable, and creative thinking. In today's world, sticking to the tried and tested isn't enough to move a business forward, or even to help it retain a comfortable and safe spot. So in today's video, I am going to share with you some of the best ideas from the book, The Creative Thinking Handbook by Chris Griffiths and Melina Costi. In today's video, you will learn how to develop and apply creativity to solve any problem. You will also gain a better understanding of your thinking. Moreover, you will discover how one simple word can solve your problem and why it helps to be emotional while taking decisions. So without any further delay, let's get started. Smart idea number 1, creativity is the new superpower of this era. You might think that learning to be more creative is only for artists and musicians. But the truth is that creativity is a skill that you need, whatever your profession. If the world was as predictable as our mornings, routine thinking and unimaginative ideas would do the trick. But we live in a fast-changing world with opportunities and challenges that require out-of-the-ordinary solutions. In this context, creativity becomes almost a superpower. In fact, in the 2016 Future of Jobs report, the World Economic Forum listed creativity, critical thinking, and problem-solving as the three most important skills to succeed in the 2020 workplace. So it is clear that creativity is the new superpower of this era. Smart idea number 2, stubbornness is the biggest enemy of creativity. Henry Ford learned this the hard way in the 1920s. At the time, Ford Motor Company sold over 60% of all cars in the US. But the market was changing. People wanted more features and more colors. Ford insisted on making black cars and limiting features to reduce cost. He even fired someone for writing a report advising against this. So when General Motors started producing what people wanted, Ford Motor Company's market share plummeted. It's normal to base decisions and ideas on knowledge or past experiences, but this stops us from seeking new information and trying other ways of doing things, both of which lead to creative ideas. Take Encyclopedia Britannica. Having sold print encyclopedias for over two centuries, the company reinvented itself digitally by challenging long-held assumptions about how people consume information. So the next time you are faced with a problem or a big decision, be wary of letting stubbornness lead you down the wrong path. Smart idea number 3, understanding is the best friend of creativity. If you have ever been around a curious child, you will know how good they are at questioning everything. Mimic them as you interrogate any challenge in your life. Ask as many questions as you can think of using the prompts what, why, where, who, when, and how. It might sound strange, but executives at Toyota have been using this tactic since the 1930s. By asking why at least 5 times, they get to the underlying details of any problem they encounter. Have you ever explained a problem to someone and they immediately started sharing ideas for solutions? Most people rush to find solutions, but the chances of coming up with a good idea this way are slim. This is because creativity calls for more than a superficial understanding of the problem. You have to dig deep. Understanding your challenge also involves borrowing perspectives. You can gain fresh insights by imagining how others would tackle the problem, from colleagues and customers to billionaires, debt philosophers, and even fairy godmothers. The more unrelated the person is, the better. Widening your perspective like this completely transforms your understanding of the challenge and opens your mind to brainstorming interesting ideas. Smart idea number 4, freedom is the biggest facilitator of creativity. When Spencer Silver, an employee of Post-it's parent company 3M, accidentally made a weak glue, he couldn't see any use for it. But years later, product development engineer Arthur Fry realized that it was great for temporarily sticking things together without damaging them. And this is how the Post-it was born. The more ideas you have, the better your chances of finding a gem like Post-it notes. And the more freedom your minds have to explore, the more ideas you will generate. This is why many big companies like Apple and Google schedule time for employees to freely explore new ideas and side projects. Letting your mind wander is a great way to discover creative ideas, and one that's been used by many brilliant minds. Some of Mozart's compositions started as melodies he thought up while taking long walks, while Albert Einstein credits daydreaming for helping him develop his theory of relativity. Having freedom to play around with metaphors of the challenge can also help find creative solutions. For example, trying to get more customers could be rephrased as trying to catch more fish. Smart idea number 5, emotion and logic both are needed to select the best ideas. According to the UK Institute of Practitioners in Advertising database, emotional ads are twice as effective as those that are logic-based. Think about it. What's more likely to get your attention? An insurance ad that explains how inexpensive a life cover is? Or one that paints a picture of how your family will be affected if you don't get insurance? Throughout life, we are asked to make choices. From small ones like what clothes to wear to more impactful ones like which college to go to. It's easy to assume that making the best decisions is a matter of what makes the most sense. But our emotions play an important role too. And it's the same when you need to choose a creative idea to go forward with. In fact, when you take emotions out of the equation, decision making becomes essentially impossible. Neuroscientist Antonio Damasio noticed this when he studied people who couldn't experience feelings and emotions because of accidents or disorders. You might think that these people would be guided by logic, but it turned out they struggled to make even the smallest decisions. Without emotions, all choices seemed equal and there was nothing to nudge them one way or another. So you need to approach all your ideas with both emotion and logic. You can do this by rating how well each idea speaks to either your heart or your head. Ask questions like whether it makes you feel good or how practical it is. If an idea scores highly on both, then you are probably onto something good. Smart idea number 6, confidence and constant supply of creativity is the oxygen for ideas. It took James Dyson 15 years and over 5,000 prototypes before he finally had his revolutionary dual cyclone bagless vacuum cleaner. And Walt Disney's first attempt at creating an animation company led to bankruptcy, not to mention being rejected a discouraging 302 times before getting the funding to set up Disney World. Without confidence, these creators would have given up at the first hurdle. Now, when the tough times are over and you can finally take in the success of your idea, you will need to keep up the creativity and direct it toward constantly improving your solution. Follow the lead of the team behind the best-selling paid app in history, Angry Birds. They iterated on the idea thousands of times, and even after the game was launched, they continued innovating with different levels and versions of the game, toys, books, and a movie. Their success is proof that creative thinking is useful long after your initial ideation. Now, if I have to summarize this whole book in just two lines, then that would be: creativity might feel like a talent that only some people are gifted with, but the reality is that anyone can become more creative. By learning how to think differently and working through the process from understanding all the way to implementation, you will develop the skills to creatively and effectively take on any challenge. As the author said, to be creative, you need to have an everything is possible mindset. If you want to take your creativity to the next level, I will definitely recommend you to read this book. You can buy this book, The Creative Thinking Handbook by Chris Griffiths and Melina Costi, from the link given below in the description. Now it's time for the most motivating comment. PSN Creations, thank you so much for your valuable feedback. We are really glad to help you. At last, a little request to you. If you have found this video useful, then please share it with your friends and family, because in this way, you can also help to change someone's life. Thanks for watching. More wisdom, more solution, better life.